Today, we're tackling a question I get asked all the time. What's the best free office suite? Whether you're writing up reports, crunching numbers, or putting together a killer presentation, you need tools that are reliable, easy to use, and most importantly, don't cost a dime. So in this video, we're comparing three of the most popular free office suites out there: WPS Office, LibreOffice, and Google Docs. Each one has its own strengths and weaknesses, and by the end of this video, you'll know exactly which one is the best fit for you. I've included links to download all three mentioned today in this video below, so if you'd like to follow along or try them out for yourself, feel free to grab those. All right, let's get into it. Let's start with WPS Office. If you've ever used Microsoft Office, this one's going to feel super familiar. It's got a sleek, modern design, and it comes with Writer, Spreadsheets, and Presentation. Basically, their versions of Word, Excel, and PowerPoint. What I love about WPS Office is how lightweight it is. It doesn't hog your computer's resources, and it works on pretty much everything. Windows, Mac, Linux, Android, iOS, you name it. Plus, it even has a built-in PDF editor, which is a nice little bonus. But here's the catch. The free version does come with ads. They're not super intrusive, but they're there. And if you want access to some of the more advanced features, you'll need to upgrade to the premium version. So who's this for? If you're looking for something polished and easy to use, and you don't mind the occasional ad, WPS Office is a solid choice. Next up, we've got LibreOffice. And this one's a bit of a powerhouse. It's completely free, open source, and packed with features. You get Writer, Calc, Impress, and even tools like Draw and Base for things like diagrams and databases. Now, the big selling point here is that it's 100% free. No ads, no subscriptions, no hidden fees. And because it's open source, it's constantly being improved by a global community of developers. It also supports a ton of file formats, including older Microsoft Office files, which is super handy if you're working with legacy documents.
That said, the interface does feel a little dated compared to WPS Office or Google Docs. It's functional, but it's not exactly flashy. And while it doesn't have built-in cloud integration, you can set it up to work with services like Google Drive or Dropbox if you're willing to make some adjustments. So if you're someone who values power and flexibility over aesthetics, LibreOffice is definitely worth checking out. Finally, let's talk about Google Docs. This one's a little different because it's entirely cloud-based. That means you can access your files from anywhere, as long as you've got an internet connection. Google Docs comes with Docs, Sheets, and Slides, which are their versions of Word, Excel, and PowerPoint. What really sets it apart, though, is the real-time collaboration. If you're working on a project with a team, this is a total game changer. You can all edit the same document simultaneously, leave comments, and see changes instantly. Now, the downside is that it's not as feature-rich as WPS Office or LibreOffice, and because it's cloud-based, you'll need to be online to get the most out of it. Formatting can also become a bit inconsistent when importing or exporting files, especially when working with complex layouts. But if you're someone who values simplicity and collaboration, Google Docs is hard to beat. So, how do these three stack up? If you want something that looks and feels like Microsoft Office, WPS Office is a great choice. Just be ready to deal with a few ads. If you're all about power, flexibility, and no strings attached, LibreOffice is the way to go. And if you're working with a team or need a cloud-based solution, Google Docs is your best bet. At the end of the day, it really comes down to what you need. Are you looking for something sleek, something powerful, or something collaborative? Let me know in the comments which one you're leaning toward. I'd love to hear your thoughts. Before you go, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to the channel for more tips, reviews, and tutorials like this one. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.